from my lovely friends at modelroundup.com. They've sent Italeri's Land Rover fire truck. It's in 1/24th scale. You can build it one of numerous ways or decorate it one of numerous ways. It is a sweet looking ride from the UK. It's got ladders, it's got hoses, it's got safety lights, it's got a spare tire on the hood, it's got spotlights, a siren. It's even got a water pump off the front bumper. This thing looks pretty cool, so I requested it. They couldn't even send it to me out of their first shipment because that shipment completely sold out. But now they've got it back in stock in limited quantities, so grab yours as soon as you can. You can search their site for Land Rover fire truck or just Italeri 3660 and snag your own. So let's take a look at what will be in the box. First, I want you to see this cool Italeri instruction manual. It's like a, it's not even line drawings. It's like photographs of the parts. I love it when they do stuff like that. I like when companies have instructions like that. They're a different look, and it actually makes things pretty easy to build a full 3D design on here. This one's got four-wheel drive. It assembles differently than a lot of US-based model cars. You can see we're going to do the inner fenders and the firewall. Then we're going to attach the dash and the pedals to it. This kit has left and right steering options, so you can build a Land Rover in the United States if you so desire. It is a four-wheel drive rig, so you just have to know that when you get into it. Also, check it out. The half, bottom half of the body that we'll see goes on the chassis, and the top half is separate, and you have to leave them separate to put all the windows in. And then at the end, you get your windshield frame, and you match them all together because there's interior details you got to work on before you put that top on it. So that's pretty cool in there. They've got numerous full-color paint guides and decal guides on the back. I think for sure I'm going to have to do a variant of the Cornwall County Fire Brigade from my man Gary out there. And it looks like a relatively simple paint scheme. It's all red with a white stripe. But of course, it's your model, so you could paint it up and do it differently as you wish. We've even got some with a white door and a white top and black wheels. I mean, just do the version that you think looks the coolest. We've got a beautiful clear parts tray. Crystal clear. We've got our headlights in there. We've got our windshield glass, our side windows with the seam on them. And then we've got our back glass. What I like about the back glass is it's one long piece. Instead of two little windows, we get one long piece. We can glue it in easier. Got our back glass and all that on there. We've got a set of five Vina rubber military style tread tires. No names on those sidewalls. It is a solid vinyl, but it is flexible. Actually, kind of smells like it might be actual real rubber. It's probably a mixture of both. The decal set is beautiful. We got those Cornwall County ones. We've got Hampshire Fire Service. We've got what looks like some German Fairwehr. We've got possible French here. Via de Limbourg. Service de Incendie. So service fire, fire service. So we got all kinds of stuff. We even got, Barcelona. We got some Spanish ones on there. Really gives you some cool options. We'll pull that out and freeze it there. A lot of stuff going on in that kit. Now we'll get to the plastic parts. It is molded in multiple colors. By multiple, I mean two. We've got our windshield frame, dashboard, steering wheel. Check out those steelies. We got our dash gauges, depending on left or right-hand drive. Got our solid axle and leaf spring suspensions. Our driver, passenger, and passenger seats, firewall, shift boots, got our drum brake system on there, transmission and transfer case. So we got all that included in there. Nice long exhaust system. Got all of our bumpers, chains. Really, everything is in there. It's a nicely detailed kit. This tree here, whoa. On this tree here, we've got a roof rack molded in one piece. I got three ladders included, which is a rarity in model kits, having all that stuff. We've got our old-timey fire extinguishers. Got our spotlights. Got our water pump housing. Got our interior water hose reel and hose halves. Got our larger hosing. That's for the stuff up here. So we've got all of that built in. This is the stand for that water pump on the inside. Really, tons of cool little deal. Work trucks are always so neat. We've got a one-piece frame, which I love. Got the bottom of the engine here, which our transmission and transfer case will bolt onto. Fuel tank hanging off the back. And then finally, we've got the bright red Land Rover body. It's the two-door model, so it's got the service bed on it. Nicely molded details all along there. It's a crisp plastic. It's not like a soft plastic. We've got a radiator we can paint back there. The common iconic Land Rover front end. Got our mount for the spare tire. Got our service bed in the back with all those details. Nice door handle moldings. Gonna have to mask those off. We can mask those off and paint those with craft paint, get those black in there. And then the top. Got the trim on the outside so we can actually get that done in black rubber. Got a windshield mount. Cut these pins off. These are just for injections. Got that. Got our back door detail. I love the drip rail and the grab rail for the roof rack all the way around the edge. You can trim that out to your heart's desire. Got our cockeyed door handle in the back like they have them. Back glass with the trim. Looks nice. I have tried dry fitting them. So when we're done, there's kind of a seam within here. We'll slide that in there. And as long as we're slow and careful with it, we should be able to get that all to glue together with a nice seam. Make sure we bring that over. Glue it on top. Get our windshield frame in there. It'll be a little fiddly. It'll take a little bit of custom fettling, but we'll get it all done, and that's all part of model building. So I'm going to start gluing my version together, and I'll be back in a moment. Thank you. Well, it's time for the sub-assembly show-off. I haven't said that in a while. Sub-assembly show-off. Remember when I started the show, I was saying that all the time. So anyways, this is that. We're going to be looking at the parts that we put together. For the most part, the kit goes together quite easily. The instructions are pretty straightforward. There's only one thing about the kit that I want to let you know about that I don't take part in, and that you can if you want to, if you want to build it up to do that. And we'll talk about that in a moment. But first up, we got the little stuff to look at. We got the cool little fire extinguishers, and those will mount inside in the truck bed. So we have those to go. We have this awesome sauce, little pump engine. That thing is so cool. Got all the valves, got the gauges. This is going to be sprayed in a main red color, and then we will go through and we will have to hand detail everything. We'll have to paint all the fixtures and stuff. You could obviously do that in advance. I'd rather have it all glued together and use my small brushes to get in there and paint it up, because it is minuscule. But it looks awesome. The black on black plastic is kind of hard to assemble because it doesn't reflect a lot of light. It's a little shiny. So when you go to get those tiny pieces in, you got to use tweezers, and it takes a couple seconds. I'm sure you saw me fumbling a little bit with my fingers. Not a huge fan of the black plastic in this small of parts and pieces. On the big rigs, it doesn't matter because the parts are so large, but on this one, it was a little confusing. We've got our firewall and inner fenders assembled. Not that we need them. I think this is pretty much just here to support the body on the frame. Got our interior floor pan. We've got our right-hand drive and our steering column in. I did not see any decals for gauges, so we will end up using a silver pencil to do just very basic gauge work. The interior is going to be black, but what sucks about this is that this whole piece snaps up inside the body, and you see I've got the shell on there so we can see that it fits together nicely once any molding points are cleaned up and all that, so we can hold that to the side. But this is actually going to snap up inside, and it snaps up there nice and tight, so that's not the issue. The issue is this top of the truck here with these little vent doors in it. That's body color on this fire truck. So to me, that's just dumb as hell. Why would you have that go together? I don't, maybe there's no other way to do it, but that's just dumb. So I'm going to have to prime this, paint this the body color. From here, I'm not going to worry about the fenders and stuff. You're never going to see them again, except for underneath the wheel wells here. So then I will have to spray this body color. Then I will have to go in and either mask that off and respray this, the interior color, or hand paint the dash, whatever I get overspray on. But that's just how that's going to have to be done. The roof rack is all set. That will need to be painted two colors, a metallic color main, and then I will hand paint the white supports that go on the truck. Unless, see, I can't tell if that's a reflection, but that can't be. That's got to be white, because otherwise that wouldn't stand out that much. But then you see it looks kind of white there, so maybe it's just all metallic and I'll leave it that way. I'm not sure. I'll think about it and decide then. We've got the hose mount for under inside the truck bed, and I've got those two pieces separated. I think I want to paint this tank a metallic color so it stands out inside the truck, and then paint the hose reel and all that black, and then paint the nozzle brass. I glued the nozzle on because it's very small. It's a butt joint, and I just want to make sure everything fit, and I can hand paint that brass anytime I want. Wheels and tires look awesome. The chassis itself goes together quite easily. The differentials, I just have to snap in the drive shafts in here. Now that I've got the transmission in there, I'm going to be doing very, very, very little underneath. I think I'm going to give it a rust coating with some dabbing on it like it's a service vehicle. Got the front bumper glued on. Do not glue on the main front bumper unless you want to exclude the hose, but I want the pump up here. So I used the two halves that they include and the pump mount. Then we go to the back. We got the differentials, we got the shocks. You saw how easily those go together. We got our drum brakes front and rear. This can have posable steering, movable steering, if you want to try to assemble all these pieces. The steering knuckles are two pieces that do not want to go together easily. Don't like how they go together. So I glue everything solid on mine. That was the part I was talking about that I don't like. That on these Italeri kits, I think these are repops of SE or MI kits maybe. I just don't like how those knuckles go together. There's no reason to have them in two pieces. You have to get them together, then you have to try to get glue on them, but not get enough glue on them that they don't ever move again. So to hell with it, I glue it all together. I glue the linkages and like the pitman, I glue that all together and make it just sit straight. So that's up to you how you want to do that, but the chassis goes together, holds itself straight, and most importantly, all four brake drums are on the ground. We don't have to worry. So we've got all the rest of the parts here. I'm going to pre-paint everything with primer. Then I'm going to cut the trees apart and start getting like wood tone on the ladder, flat black on the hoses. I may cut them apart before I paint. It depends on how I feel. But anyways, now that we've got all that going, I'm going to get over to the paint section right now. You can see what colors I'm going to use.
Bomba, bomba, para siempre. Bomba, bomba.
almost to the end of my little fire truck build. It's going pretty well, not having any issues. The windshield actually friction fits between the frames of the door, and then that just drops right over the top. So we can start taking a look at what we've done here. We've got our spotlight all set to go, and on the model it says for the addition I'm building, that will go on this side of the kit, I'm assuming, so that the passenger, the assistant driver, he can aim it. I've got some very small parts to attach. We've got our mirrors and we've got our windshield wipers. Those will have to go on before we're all done. And then up here, our siren, which will go on the front fender and just glue in flat. So we'll start pulling things apart because it's actually just kind of resting together in this position. And you watch me work on the video, you saw this, my buddy Gary, the Cornwall County Fire Brigade is going to have to go on there. But when I talked to Gary, he said use the ECV license plate, that the CV license plate, not the YGL. He said use that one, should be correct for Cornwall. And since he's from there, that's what I'm going to trust. I'm going to believe that, and that's not going to take any suggestions to anything otherwise except someone who actually lives there. So we'll take off the roof rack, which is really cool, and just rests right on those drip rails. So there's no need to glue this in place if you don't want to. The blue lights look awesome. In the United States, I'm used to reds and blues, but these are all blue lights on this one. I did the rack all in the aluminum, then I hand painted, and then I sprayed the tips with the chrome. That looks pretty cool. And it actually fits on there either way. So, you know, you can put it on there however you decide. I'll match the box art and everything, but looks awesome with the little ladders. That's all super glued together. That's going to be nice. And then we've got our sweet spare tire. It showed on the Cornwall one that it had the white wheels, and I like that look with that, with the white stripe down the side at the body seam. Look at the pump here. There's no decals provided for the pump, but it does look awesome. That silver paint really came out nice. Really dried shiny. So that pump's just going to rest in there. I'll just drop some super glue in that cradle and set it in there when we're all done. The top will take off gently. Got all the glass glued in. You can see the windshields in, the sidebars for the glass, and then there's your rear door with the door handles and all the glass glued in. No problems with that, and that seems to be just kind of resting over the top, so I'm not really going to have to glue it in. Then we've got our hose reel and our tank inside, and the two fire extinguishers. And I didn't do them in red, I just left them in the chrome color of the old style. Then we've got our nice little gas cap on there. We've got our tail lights and turn signals. We've got our handles. We've got our license plate frame. We've got the chassis glued in. We've got our exhaust and our drive shafts located. That's all the detailing I did on that. The interior snapped in without a problem. There's an interior wall here for the cargo area, and that just snaps into place. With here, we've got our drive shaft, or we've got our gear levers and everything, steering wheel, and you saw how I did the gauges, super simple, so there's no decals provided. And then we've got our exterior air intake with our door handles that we masked off. I don't think I'm going to be putting any floor polish on this at all. That red paint is more than shiny enough for a service vehicle, so I think I'm going to be leaving it. That cherry red just came out beautifully. On the front, we've got our headlights in with our headlight protectors. We've got that awesome little grill over the black painted for the radiator behind it. And then we've got our marker light and our turn signals on the front. And that's it. Super simple. Just gonna glue those last pieces on, do my decals, let it all dry up, and then we will be back for that final. Well, how cool is this, my peeps? We got an awesome little Land Rover fire truck. I love all the options on this thing. I like seeing work vehicles from other countries. The fact that it has some Cornwall County Fire Brigade logos on the doors for my buddy Gary over there even makes it better. So no real issues with final assembly. The chassis glues onto the body quite easily. The interior snaps in. The top isn't even held on with any glue, so you could technically remove it Just be very, very careful of those windshield wipers because they do fit over the edge of the glass, so you'll want to pry those out before you take it apart. But this is cool looking. This is really nice. I like the white stripe down the side that they do for the Cornwall. Maybe if I ever redid it, I'd paint a different version. I'd want that white roof on there. I think that would look really awesome too, but I enjoyed this kit. It all went together quite easily. I didn't have any problems. The decals took a little bit longer to come off the paper, but once they did, they were strong and they have a very strong color. You can see that white of the lettering. We're not getting any bleed through on the red paint, which sometimes will happen. The wheels look pretty darn cool. And then I painted the hubs black to match the box art. The hubs look like they stick out a little bit more than they would in real life. They look like they, in real life, they look like they'd come out about 4 inches. And I think they've got them closer to 7. They look like big nipples on the side of this thing. So it's pretty funny. But doing the details was not hard at all. In fact, I would say the most difficult thing was masking and painting those door handles on the back and on the sides, and even that wasn't a challenge. You saw me do it. Did the black marker around the side. The roof rack looks awesome. All the hoses, the ladders, the blue lights are really cool. The only thing it's missing is a little sound card. So it goes neener, neener, neener. Completely different noise they make over in the UK than they do in the United States, but I enjoyed the build. All the lights go into place where they should. All the little handles, the mirrors plug right in with some thick gel super glue. And like I said, the windshield frame just snapped in place. I thought it was going to be kind of a pain putting the interior in since part of the exterior is part of the interior, but I was worried for nothing. It all went in just fine. I masked it off, it painted, then I hand painted the top of the dashboard, did the decals. You really can't see much inside, even though it has a ton of windows. But even then, you can still pull that roof off and see the hose reel inside and the fire extinguisher. So Model Roundup has these little beauties in stock. You can either search Land Rover fire truck or Model 3660, or just click on their website where it says new arrivals, and it will be on there with some other cool stuff like the mini art tractor you saw in the new kits video this weekend. You saw this, we're gonna see that tractor get built up. I'm gonna have them send over the new Atlantis Studebaker dragster. Maybe if they're watching this, they'll just send it. Otherwise, I'll send them an email and say, hey, I wanna build that up. I know you guys wanna see that too. Italeri's got so many cool kits out. You saw that big 1/12 scale Bugatti that I'm going to be building up on the channel. I did the unboxing of it. I just have to find time to get that on there. We'll do that. They've got a lot of other cool kits in 1/24 scale. And as you see, they come out and they look so cool. I just love how this thing looks. It's going to look great. And every time I see it, it'll remind me of my buddy Gary over in the UK, who builds, I would have to say, of all the modelers I know, personally, I don't know a lot of modelers personally, but Gary is someone I talk to at least on a weekly basis. He makes the absolute finest models. I wish he'd do more with his channel. So in the comments, just say, Gary, we want to see more of your models because he does gorgeous models. Plus, that English accent is cool to listen to when he does them. So again, thanks to my buddy Gary for letting me know about the Cornwall and the license plate. We got this built up for you, my little tribute to Gaz the K's model channel over there. I enjoy watching his stuff on the rare chance that he puts a video out. Would love to see more. Thanks to modelroundup.com for this kit. You can snag this from them. They ship anywhere in the world. And I want to thank all of you, as always, for inspiring me to build my models my way, to have fun doing it, and that I really enjoy reading your comments and suggestions below the videos. We'll see all of you at the next review.